And what is going on, everybody, and welcome back to another Java game development video. This video will go over the process I went through when building the Tetris in Java, as well as me enjoying the almost final build. Let's get right into it. My goals for this project was to make the game within 2 days. I'm not the best in Java, however, I've been working heavily with it since my college focuses computer science around it. I tried to make this game pretty efficient, and I haven't made a Java game in years, so I'm a little rusty at the start. I'll be going over the main classes and the theory of how I set this game up. Don't forget the code will be on my newly designed website, niha.com. You can also check out more of my Java projects here, or discover other projects you may like. To start, I have the controller class. In the long run, this class manages rendering, ticking, and initialization of other classes. Next, we have the starting menu file. The methods are pretty self-explanatory, but I wanted to add a moving background to make the menu stand out more. To do this, I would create another thread that ticks and eventually spawns pieces. The array of pieces would fall down on the screen during each tick. Then I incorporated a couple extra features, such as visiting my website, and some cool images, such as the Tetris logo and my website logo. Next, if we click on the high scores screen, it will display the top 5 high scores. There is a text file that generates on the computer, which stores these scores. In the future, I want to encrypt the files so that the user cannot tamper with them and change their scores. I obviously have a key handler class and mouse handler classes that enable the keyboard and mouse detection. These files are pretty basic and don't require too much work to learn, so I'm not going to go over them too much. Now it's time for the game class where all of the action is. So how this game works is that there's a double array of integers. This is initialized with the width and height of the game board and is filled with zeros. The zeros represent empty spots, and any number that is greater than zero represents a certain colored of Tetris block. For each digit, I display a Tetris block from this picture and I split it accordingly to the values of the positions in the array. For example, if this is my array, I would render the 4 values as green because it is the 4th position of this image. Pretty much, I split the image up in 8 different positions, and the first position is transparent. After rendering all of the images, I have a function that is called updateBlockPosition. Every time the clock thread ticks, it will move the current block down. If there is a block underneath it, it spawns a new block and keeps the old one in the same position. I have a class called piece, which represents the current and the next upcoming piece. The control piece is the current piece that is movable. When moving left and right, I first check to see if the new spot that I move into contains any values that are higher than 0 in the game array. In other words, I check to see if there's a block that is going to prevent me from moving into the new position. Similarly, I do the same check after the user presses the up arrow to rotate the current piece. I create a temporary array, which is the rotated value of my current piece. I check to see if the rotated value is colliding with a value that is greater than 0 in the game array. If there is a non-zero block in any of the positions that my current block needs to go into, then it won't rotate. Afterward, when a whole line contains values that are greater than 0, I remove the whole entire row and shift all of the above values down and increase the player's score. The trickiest part about this project is the nested for loops. It gets a little confusing looping through the width and height of multiple double arrays at the same time. The scoring in my game is roughly the same as a classic Tetris game. I haven't played too many games of Tetris, so I had to use the Wikipedia page to learn more about it. Anyway, in the player class, it simply contains the level the player is currently at and the score. From what I gathered, this is the function that calculates the score. Every 10 lines cleared will increase the player level by 1. If one line is cleared, the score will increase by 40 multiplied by the level plus 1. The highest way to increase your score is to get Tetris, which is when you clear all 4 lines at the same time. That is the maximum amount of lines the player can clear at once, and is very complex to do, which is why it grants the player the most points based on the equation. Additionally, the score will be increased by 1 every time the player quick drops an item by pressing down on the arrow keys. There's a difference between hard dropping a piece and soft dropping, but I don't know enough about Tetris to implement this in my game yet. The max level from what I gathered is 9, so after 90 lines cleared, the player will be capped out at level 9 for the rest of the round. Now since you guys have an idea of how this works, let's have some fun. It takes a little bit to load at the start, but that's normal. So as you can see, you have the falling bricks in the background, which I thought was pretty cool. It adds to the game. I have this Tetris logo that I made and a little feature at the bottom, which goes to my website if you click the visit my website button. You also have the high scores, which loads the high scores from the text file that is generated on the user's computer when the program is booted up. So if we go ahead and click the new game button, here is the game. You can start another new game while you're in the game if you messed up and you want a quick restart. There's a show guide button and a main menu button that goes back to the main menu. If I click the show guide button, it draws where your piece is going to land. Eventually I want it to show a silhouette of just your piece of where it's going to land to make it even more easier to read. So if we take the guide off, the score, every time I press down on the keypad, the score goes up one because that's originally how it's supposed to be played. You can use WASD or you can use the arrow keys to play this game. I don't really know the best strategy to this game, but I'm just gonna try my best. These are also images that are being drawn right now. I made images for each one of these blocks. So there, I just cleared a line and I got 40 points for it because we're still in level 0. The best way to go is to keep pressing the down on the D-pad, but this way you get the most points possible. Oh, here we go. I should have played. Oh, wait, there we go. This is almost Tetris, but I didn't get it quite yet. I'm gonna go for it right now because I don't think I'll be able to stay alive much longer. So as you guys could see, there was a glitch up there where every once in a while, one of the pieces gets stuck up there. I don't really know what's going on, but that's the only bug in the game currently. So we got 750 points. That was a high score. I'm gonna go ahead and play another game for you guys. See how well I do this time. Maybe I can try going for Tetris. I don't think so. This spawning. Thank you. that's all I have for this video. I hope you all enjoyed it. Don't forget to leave a like and to drop a comment down below. As a reminder, the code can be found on my website, niha.com, which will be linked in the description. Thanks for watching.